You are in the power zone now with DU. DU's Power Zone.
The Power Zone with DU is dedicated to bringing you insightful communication and resources that will guide you further in making your personal and professional goals a reality. Through candid, stimulating, and essential conversations, we focus on the 9 universal goals of success, which include career, finances, education, family, arts, attitude, health and wellness, leisure, and public service. Based upon these goals, we provide you, the listener, with practical measures of advancement. Good evening, family, and welcome to the Power Zone with DU. Again, welcome to the Power Zone with DU. I am your host, Darlene A. Anderson, motivational speaker, philanthropist, life and professional consultant, and author of Not Without a Fight, 10 Ways to Win When It Appears As If You've Already Lost. And you, my friend, have entered the Power Zone with DU. Welcome, everybody. Welcome. And Happy New Year. It is 2016. We have been on hiatus for a while, the last couple of months. In 2015, we were on hiatus, preparing to bring you the very best of the best for 2016, and we are ready to go. We have a lineup of great guests. We have great sponsorship. We're bringing you great materials to help you elevate to your highest level of potential, personally and professionally, through great stimulating conversation. That is what we do here on the Power Zone with DU. And for 2016, baby, and yes, I said baby, we are busting through the seams with great conversations to do just that. Now, if you're joining us for the very first time, welcome. We are so excited to have you out here. We want you to feel like family. We want you to tweet it out, Facebook it out, link it out, Instagram it out, put it on our website. We just want you to just share information about the Power Zone with DU to help empower others. And if you're joining us, well, welcome back. We are sorry that you had to wait for so long, but again, we are back and we are bringing you bigger and better for 2016. Now, for many of you that want to know exactly what is the Power Zone with DU, the Power Zone with DU is a component of Darlene's Utopia. Darlene's Utopia is a New York-based full-service consulting company founded in 2008 with the mission to empower, motivate, and provide resources for clients through consulting, advocacy, and events. Our goal is to help our clients reach their highest personal and professional potential. And here at the Power Zone with DU, we are doing just that. Now, we have a little announcement to make as far as our expansion goals. Now, we've taken the Power Zone with DU to the next level for 2016, and we're actually bringing you DU Radio, and DU Radio will be a component of Darlene's Utopia just the same. Through DU's radio, we'll be doing more interviewing. We'll be featuring other people that might want to come on and present materials on our show or independent of our show through our platform of DU Radio. We'll be speaking a little more about that in the upcoming weeks, but I want you all to get ready because DU Radio, we're going to a whole nother level to bring you that insightful communication you need to help bring about productivity into the new year. That being stated, we're going to go out on a little break. And when we come back, family, I'm going to speak to our topic for the evening from our entrepreneurs. Are you ready? This show is dedicated just for you. We'll be back after the break, family.
Darlene's Utopia is a full-service consulting company
created to empower, motivate, and provide resources for clients through coaching, speaking engagements, and events. Our goal is to help clients and event attendees reach their highest personal and professional potential. To learn more about Darlene's Utopia, log on to www.darlenesutopia.com. Welcome back, family. I am your host, Darlene A. Anderson, and you have re-entered the Power Zone with DU. I know on the break you all heard a little bit more about Darlene's Utopia. I am excited to let you know that the Making of Moguls and Entrepreneurs Conference, a component of Darlene's Utopia, will be back for 2016. Get ready, get ready, get ready. It is coming. Now, for some of you that are tuning in for the first time and you haven't heard about the Making of Moguls, the Making of Moguls is an entrepreneurs conference that we do every year, and it helps entrepreneurs no matter where you're at. You can be in the beginning stages, in the intermediate stages, in the advanced stages. The Making of Moguls is an opportunity for you to come out and you to get everything that you need in your business to be further successful or to help you in your development stage. So I invite everyone to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and get more information as it's given as it relates to the Making of Moguls. It's definitely going to be bigger and better. Acknowledgements to all of my great people that have been a part of it. Dr. Oliver T. Reed, Renee Flagler, Chase, just a name, just a few. It's just so many. And we're definitely going to bring you bigger and better in the new year. That being stated, 2016, I feel as if it is a time to continue what we did in 2015, what has not been completed, what we need to continue to do, what we need to kind of tweak and do. So 2015 was kind of, for me, the year of completion. This is the year kind of continuation. So if you completed tasks and then you got yourself new assignments in 2015, you're going into 2016 now continuing what the assignment is. Whatever your assignment is, you're definitely taking it to the next level. That's what 2016 is for me. It's just a clean transition of continuation. That being stated, entrepreneurship. We have been big here at the Power Zone with DU in bringing you all materials to help you take, again, your business to the next level. And I wanted to come on the call and speak about entrepreneurship as it relates to the power of networking. Everybody say it with me. The power of networking. There is an art in networking, and we speak about that quite frequently on the show. But I wanted really to just address a couple of nuggets. Something that will help some of you out there that have your plan and you're ready to launch or relaunch or continue it. As I said, 2016 is a year of completion. So you're continuing that plan as it relates to your business. And I think that there's really a missing piece. I was speaking to some of my colleagues about this. There is a missing piece in networking that unfortunately some of us, even myself, either never learned or tend to forget. So let's share some of those nuggets on the call this evening. What motivated me to speak about this, I was listening to some of our archives and I referenced a call back in July of 2015 with Ms. Noni Fanta Respass. Yes, Ms. Noni Fanta Respass, who is a great friend of mine. I take her to be a great friend as well as a colleague. Noni is a lifestyle manager and the founder of Noni Knows Things. Now, on the show with Noni, we actually reference a great article through a blogger, Evan Carmichael, and you guys can Google him. His name is Evan Carmichael again, and he featured an article through an author, Boney Albo. And Boni Albo actually talked about the daily activities of an entrepreneur. These are the main activities that an entrepreneur will do on a daily basis, interchangeably, usually by themselves or with minimal staff. That would be accounting, administration, computer work, correspondence, human resources, sales, troubleshooting, warehousing, and your own job duties. That would be maybe if you're a hairstylist or a landscaper or a tattoo artist or you're a baker, you're going to do all of that in addition to what your specialty is. Now, it's funny because when I went over this back in July, we really didn't touch on what I'm touching on today. We were in a total other area that was more relevant to Noni and the services that she provided. But what really got me in preparation of this call is that networking is not listed here. Networking is not listed here. And networking is actually one of the key components of being an entrepreneur. It is one of the key duties, the key responsibilities. Because why? It's about relationships. And what do you need to take your business to the next level, to meet your bottom line? Relationships. You need clients. You need people. You have to have someone that you're able to convey your mission to, your services to, so then they can in return buy from you. Supply and demand. Networking. So this call, we're going to speak a little bit about networking, the power of networking. In my research, there were actually three things that I wanted to speak to on this call. And I'm going to let you guys grab a pen and paper, and we're going to speak a little bit about three key points as it relates to the power of networking. You ready, family? Here we go. Establishing and maintaining great networks. Values. Your values are extremely important because your values trickle into your behavior. Your behavior trickles into your etiquette of how you're doing things. Now, as I'm saying these words, I know some of you are smiling. Some of you may say, what is she talking about? But then some of you are smiling because when I say etiquette, you know exactly what I mean. Maintaining good etiquette is important. Etiquette is a lost art, but it's extremely important in networking. And the final is preparation. Preparation. Now let's talk about them in no particular order. I like preparation. We'll start with preparation first. It is so relevant, and I've had a lot of speakers on the Power Zone when we've discussed communication. Toastmasters with Mr. Mark Williams, and we spoke to communicating, but not just communicating, an art to communicating. There is an art to speaking when you are in the business of people. Toastmasters is one of the greatest clubs across the world to help you as a public speaker take your business to the next level. One of the things that I enjoyed in speaking with Mark that we discussed was preparation. Going back and listening to yourself speak. Going back and studying your elevator pitch. Sitting down and writing about yourself. All of this is preparation. You can't sell yourself if you don't know how to present yourself, if you don't know how to speak about yourself, if you don't know how to speak about your company, if you don't know how to speak about your products, and if you're not able to do that within a timely manner where you're giving a little bit, but people want to hear more later on. You ever speak to somebody and they give you a whole 2-minute presentation, uninvited too, I'm gonna say that. uninvited. They'll give you, you'll meet them at an event, and then they'll just go in with all of these things that they feel you should know about them, but they're not really giving you an opportunity to ask your questions. There's no breaks. So by the time they're finished, you're just wanting to walk away because you really feel at that point you know everything and you don't want to know more just based on that moment. How do you engage people? You practice it. You practice your elevator speech. You practice about your products. You practice about your services, and you engage them within that 30 seconds to a minute and 30 seconds, depending on what you have. You engage them in that time so they want to know more. And again, the only way to do that is preparation. There are so many great tools to assist you with that online. Free things. Look up elevator pitches. Look up what it takes to do a great sales pitch. If you don't know what an elevator pitch is, Google it. Sales pitch, Google it. If you don't know how you should talk about yourself, Google it or call Darlene A. Anderson, your professional consultant, and I will definitely help you in that. And in that moment, I just sold myself. So we have be prepared. Entrepreneurs, be prepared to network. Networking should never be impulsive. It should never be something that you should just go out and do. It is always about taking the time to prepare and ensuring that when you go out, you're doing it, because you only get one opportunity at times. On that note, I'm going to go out on a little break with one of my favorite songs. Of course, Eminem, Lose Yourself.
Yo. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out, time's up, over, plow. Snap back to reality, oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes rabbit, he choked. He's so mad, but he won't give up. Daddies, he know he won't have it, he knows. His whole back to these ropes, it don't matter, he's dope. He knows that, but he's broke. He's so stagnant, he knows. When he goes back to this mobile home, that's when it's back to the lab again, yo. This old rhapsody, better go capture this moment and hope it don't do better. Lose yourself in the music, the moment you own it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime, you better lose yourself in the music, the moment you own it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime.
Welcome back, family. You have re-entered the Power Zone with DU. I am your host, Darlene A. Anderson, and we are discussing the power of networking for my entrepreneurs out here on this evening. So if you're tuned in just at this segment right here, we definitely want you to rewind and listen to the prior segments. But for this moment, we'll share with you what we were discussing, those three nuggets, all right? I'm going to give you guys those three nuggets again. Establish and maintain networks. Good values. Your good values are measures of your behavior, also your etiquette. So good values, having good etiquettes. How are you as an entrepreneur when networking? And then also preparation, being prepared. So some of you on the call, some of my seasoned entrepreneurs, this may be nothing to you. You do it with your eyes closed. But hopefully there's something in here that you can take away from or share it with someone that you feel doesn't possess these things. It's our charge. If we have colleagues, I have a lot of individuals that I consider not just to be business associates, my colleagues, my dear friends. I have a lot of people on the show. If I say you're my dear friend, then I have a charge to ensure if you have a business and I see that there's something that you can do to take your business to the next level, I'm going to share it with you. So be charged. Feel as if it is your obligation to share these things with people that you call dear friends. We use the word nowadays, sis. Everybody's my sister. Everybody's my brother. If you're calling somebody your sister or your brother, you have an obligation to ensure that that person is in the know of these nuggets. So before the break, we discussed preparation. Now let's discuss establishing and maintaining networks. That has a lot to do with preparation. If you are preparing yourself accordingly, then you will be able to establish and maintain your network. So what happens when you meet an individual and you get those cards? What are you doing with those business cards when you come home? May she rest in peace. The late, great Miss Cherise Patterson of Simply to Empower. She was phenomenal, phenomenal. Cherise spoke a lot about categorizing your business cards, filing them accordingly, sending out letters shortly after you've met an individual. There is a time in which when you meet someone, you're supposed to send out an email to acknowledge meeting them and to see where you go from there. There's a process to it. Darlene A. Anderson, professional consultant, can help you on that path. If you are unknowing of what exactly to do when you meet someone, what's the time? Should you send it in a week? Should you send it in 2 weeks, 48 hours? Should you call or email? There is a variety of things in which you can do just to maintain that relationship, but you need to do it. You need to do it quickly. The turnaround is very limited, and the sooner people meet you is the sooner they can forget about you. So you definitely want to ensure that when you're establishing these relationships, you are maintaining them. I'm very happy to say Darlene's Utopia has been in existence since 2008. And the individuals that I started out with are the individuals that I maintain within my networks. Some of them may not be responsive to emails, whereas some of them, I've been maintaining conversations, I've been doing events with them, I've collaborated on various projects from 2008 to now. But there is a directory in which mostly a vast majority of everyone that I've met that I've gotten a business card from, I can go back and I can reference that card. And it's not just enough to just take a business card. When you're taking business cards, you're thinking of what you can do with those cards. Where can I work with this person? What can I do in this situation? You're always thinking about those type of things. And also reciprocity. Reciprocity is extremely important as it relates to establishing and maintaining networks. When you're talking about relationships, it is imperative that you give out what you're expecting to get in. So that means if I want to partner with you and it's more beneficial for me in January and you agree to come out with me in January, then the second quarter when you have your event, I need to show up and I need to be available for you just the same. Because when you do not show up and there's no type of reciprocity, then in the long run, you are shortening your network. People know. The word goes around very, very quickly. So you always want to make sure that what you're asking of others, you're giving just the same. You're a person of integrity. And now we're actually going into good values, good etiquette. Are you a person of integrity? Do you mean what you say and say what you mean? Are you a person that you let your personal get in the way of professional? And as entrepreneurs, it's a little different because it's not necessarily corporate. It's not 9 to 5. We're in the business of people. We're dealing with people on different levels, especially some of my life coaches on the call, some of my motivational speakers, some of my personal consultants. You guys understand that when you're dealing with people on these levels and you're building relationships, sometimes the boundaries get a little blurred. Sometimes you feel like you don't necessarily have to be as professional as you would if you were corporate or 9 to 5, but you do. You have to maintain professionalism. Those etiquettes should remain the same all the time. All the time. Are you angry if something doesn't go your way and you're sharing it? Don't work with her. Don't work with him. Oh, I don't know. I wouldn't think. I didn't have a good experience. Although it is your right to say what you need to say, keep in mind as a professional, your etiquettes are extremely important as it relates to how people perceive you. One of the things that I speak to my young people, I do work readiness for 16 to 24 year olds. And we speak about when you get fired from a job, how do you convey that to your future employer? How do you convey that to someone who may ask you about that company and they get upset? We go back and forth. Oh, I'm going to tell them exactly how I feel and what they did. But at the end of the day, it's not about your past. It's about your future. And your future doesn't want to know all of those negative things, because then your future is going to look at it and say, well, what happens with us if you don't like something that we do? How will you talk about us? So you're kind of losing out from the gate. And as entrepreneurs, sometimes we tend to do that. And it's very important that your etiquettes remain stable and always on a professional level. Remain professional at all times, family. I am so excited about 2016. We have much more to go. I have confirmed with my dear mentor and good friend, Miss Stacy NC Grant, on the call, and we're going to be discussing professional development. She's going to share all her happenings, and we're going to give continued nuggets for my entrepreneurs to be successful into 2016. I'd like to close out in sharing a little information about something in which I'm extremely passionate about, and that's Utopia Network Inc. Utopia Network Inc. is a nonprofit organization here in New York City in which I serve as the president and CEO. It is something that is near and dear to my heart. I'm excited about servicing the underserved population within Brooklyn and beyond. And our mission is to connect individuals and families with services that will promote stability and a better quality of life. We are committed to ensuring that the underserved communities have an understanding of the tremendous opportunities for productivity in their adversities and move to actions of advancement. Family, I invite you to log on to Utopia Network Inc., learn more about the organization, and get involved. We're bringing about awareness and education. We're helping change lives, and we definitely can utilize your services. Whether you're forwarding the information online or passing it on, now is the time to get involved and be a part of the change in which you want to see. On that note, I bid you all an extreme good evening. It is a pleasure. Again, 2016 is our year. I am looking forward to seeing you guys out here each and every week as we're bringing insightful and stimulating conversation your way. Until next time, be well and be safe. The content of the Power Zone with DU, a component of Darlene's Utopia, is intended for general information purposes only. The views expressed by the show's hosts and their guests are their own and shall not be construed in any way as advice from the Power Zone with DU or Darlene's Utopia. Personal perspectives expressed by the producer, writers, editors, hosts, and guests will always be presented as such. We encourage you to seek professional advice for any problem in which you may have. No liability, explicit or implied, shall be extended to Darlene's Utopia or the Power Zone with DU.